excellence. We're good. You know, and I think when Nick starts talking about compensation and everything, it's like a lot of boxers, they'll box themselves for free,
right,
or they'll charge a certain camp X amount of money. All of a sudden, when it's the box in our camp, their money doubles or triples, and it just gets ridiculous. You know what I mean? He's trying to get around it in his own way. He doesn't see the stuff that we're doing, you know, from a management perspective and everything. But it's difficult right now. It is.
Definitely.
Is that really what Nick was talking about with the whole frustration with camp? Because
yeah, absolutely.
I think a lot of people they see that,
and
they
then,
think
but
you're
then he
camp,
tried
you know?
To clarify it, and he thinks he is by saying, no, I got a great type of guy. I got Jake Shields, Gilbert Melendez,
right,
Nate Diaz. He's got a top boxing coach. You know, we've got a great jiu-jitsu program. But in order for us to make certain things happen, I mean, obviously people have to help a little bit too, you know.
Right.
And people don't necessarily want to go to Stockton and hang out and you know, they want the big money for something like that. Or they won't do it at all.
Right.
You know what I mean? That's the problem we have.
Cesar, I wanted to ask you real quick. GSP was pro MMA now. And I just wanted to ask you real quick. Georges St-Pierre was cornering Francis Carmon tonight. And at one point, right after the banners were unfurled, he jumped down off the cage. Is that something you would do 10 days after a knee injury?
You know, he ran past me earlier.
Oh, that's true.
I mean, he literally ran past me. So, I look, he's a great guy. He's a black belt under Cesar Gracie. I don't know the guy that well personally, but I'm going to tell you something right now. Nick Diaz missed a press conference, and he's here and fought. You know, the guy that went to the press conference didn't fight. That's all I got to say about it. Nick, yeah, he got kicked out. He's the bad guy. Look, you didn't go to your, like what Nick called the beauty pageant. But on come fight night, you guys saw what he's made of, and he showed up, and he did everything he had to. And the guys that made the press conference, they weren't here tonight. So you be the judge.
Do you think GSP was not injured then?
I'm not going to say that. I have no idea. But I'm saying Nick was injured, and he still fought. Nick hurt his hamstring. He's got a knee injury. You know what I mean? There's this, that. I mean, these fighters, they train so hard that they're going to get the injuries and everything. But despite his injuries, that guy was here for the fans, and he's a warrior, just like BJ. You know what I mean? I think people appreciate that. But, you know, one guy jumping off the cage, running around, it makes us, you know, it's disheartening is all I'm going to say about it. You know what I mean?
Cesar, Nick,
where are you from?
From onemania.com, MMA. Nick talks about getting paid, like Floyd Mayweather and Manny Pacquiao, but and he also says he doesn't like going to the press conferences where people meet each other and like get friendly with each other. But top boxers do that, and
yeah.
Floyd Mayweather and Manny Pacquiao.
Nick's got to do that for sure. I'm not siding on him with that particular thing. I think he should have gone to the press conference. I think he's frustrated because I don't think he believed that they would have taken him out of the fight. He doesn't, you know, they should have fined him, and I've said that before. I was so mad at Nick, and Nick's like family to me and everything, and I understood Dana. You guys saw the phone call or whatever, but I don't think he should have been pulled out of that fight. Now, in hindsight, I'm glad he did. I'm glad it happened because, look, GSP would have pulled out no matter what. Let's face it, okay? And, you know, Nick got to fight tonight and got to show everybody what, you know, I've said it so many times, what level he's at, and he is at that level, and I think tonight everybody got to see that.
But don't you think being taken out of the fight was a proper punishment and fine?
Like I said, I'm not Dana. He's the guy that makes a decision like that. He looks at things from an angle that I'm not at. He's the promoter. He's taking care of his business. Maybe I would have done the same thing if I were he. You know what I'm saying? I'm looking at it from my perspective. And from my perspective, then no. Fine him, you know, whatever. But, you know, I don't think the people, the fans, care if he goes to a media press conference. I don't. They care if he does what he did tonight. And that's what he did. And the other guy didn't. That's all I'm saying. Is that it? All right. Thank you, guys. Thank you.